Folks, this is Military Surplus Wednesday. My name is Luke. Thank you for tuning in to the Outdoor Gear Review. In my hand here, I have the Israeli Poncho Liner. And this is something that is going to interest a lot of you all, because I know you guys love Military Surplus just as much as I do. Think of this product as the Israeli version of the Woobie Blanket, or the GI Poncho Liner. This is the Israeli version. As you can see here, this is very good sized. Let's take a look at it, shall we? When it comes to the weight of the Israeli Poncho Liner, you are looking at roughly 1.5 pounds. The cost of this bad boy is $40, and you can find this at the thunderheadoutfitters.com. I have not seen this Poncho Liner being offered anywhere else except by them. This is definitely a hard to find product, but they have it in stock. This is genuine military surplus issued to the Israeli Defense Force, also known as the IDF. As you can see here, it's solid green, quilted on both sides, and the dimensions are 77 inches by 54 inches. And as you can see, this is a very simple blanket. There's no loops, attachment points around this thing at all. It's very thin. This offers you the barest amount of warmth and cushion. Now, in some situations, that's a very good thing. Like now in the summer, you don't need a big blanket, right? This is by far much thinner than the Woobie blanket. This is very, very thin. Just enough, like say if you were to sit on this, just enough to kind of give you some cushion off of the ground. You can use this as a mat. You can use this as a warm summer blanket. You can cover your gear with this. You could even use this with a hammock system, but you will have to attach some loops on the sides because there are none as it stands now. Honestly, folks, there are aspects to this blanket here that I like better than the Woobie blanket. First off, it is thinner. It's lighter weight. And that makes it perfect for those hot summer nights where you don't need a thick blanket. Now, if you guys are interested in the future, I will do a direct comparison. It's up to you. Just comment down below. Let me know what your thoughts are and I'll get to it if you're interested, of course. As a lover of military surplus, I love this blanket. This thing is awesome. Excellent quality. Very, very good stitching on this thing here. Very comfortable just to lay on the ground. You could definitely use this as a mat. You know, you could even use this as a sleeping pad. You could fold it over, double it up, plenty of cushion. This would be more comfortable than many foam mats on the market. It looks like I have about 5 minutes before it starts raining, so let's wrap this up here. All right, we'll go ahead, roll this up for you all. So as you can see there, it's all rolled up. This is reasonably tight. Don't expect to get this much more compressed than this. Before wrapping up this video, when it comes to the materials, I do believe this is polyester inside and out. You know, when it comes to this material here, it is slightly rough. It's definitely not as smooth and silky as, say, the Woobie blanket. Definitely rougher. Not uncomfortable against the skin by any means, but quite a bit rougher. It doesn't pull any hair out on your face or anything like that. That's a huge plus. All right, guys, $40, Israeli military surplus. What do you guys think about this here? Are you willing to trade in your Woobie blanket for this one? I will go ahead and answer that question. No, I'm not. But there is a place for this. There's no doubt about that. If you want the comparison video, make sure to comment down below and let me know. Until next time, everyone, strength and honor. If you guys have any questions for me, email me. I answer every single email that is sent. I cannot go through all the comments. I'm sure you guys understand. Until next time, take care, strength and honor.